This is Pavitra, school assistant biological science from ZPHS Gaddipalli. Today I am going to talk about the history of cell division. In the previous classes we have seen about the asexual reproduction, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Now let us see how new cells are formed in living beings. How this cell division leads to formation of new organisms in some animals, in some living organisms. First, answer these questions. How new cells are formed in living beings? New cells, what is the need of new cells in our body? Our body needs new cells because every day we are losing some cells from our body. Every day few cells are dying. For example, the lifespan of RBC is only 120 days. WBC's lifespan is 13 to 20 days. Our skin cells, our intestine cells, all cells from different organs die, and some cells arise or some cells produced in those organs in place of the dead cells. How do these new cells form? Because the division occurs in the cells which are there in the organism, in the organ. Because of the division in the cells gives rise new cells. That new cells occupies the space of dead cells. Okay. How do our wounds get healed after few days? If we observe, when a person get an wound, after 10-15 days that wound will be healed and only the scar on that place we can see. What happened in these 15 days? The cells around the wound undergo number of mitotic divisions. Because of that mitotic divisions, new cells are formed. That new cells occupied the space of wound. And gradually that wound is filled with totally new cells. Finally, wound get healed. This is how the cell division replaces the dead ones, and it helps in the formation of reproductive cells. Let us see who worked in this area, in the field of cell division. Who discovered the cell division first? What is cell division? From this lesson, the learner going to learn that identifies the work of scientists to find the history behind the formation of new cells and organisms, appreciates the work of scientists in finding the cell division, gives reason for the number of chromosomes are constant over generations, explains about the importance of genetic material. First, the scientist Robert Remarque worked in the field of cell division. That means he only first published his observation on cell division in 1852. He stated that binary fission of cells was the means of reproduction of animal cells. Here you know what is reproduction means. Re means same, producing the same ones. Reproduction happens in all living organisms. That means neem plant can produce only neem plants. Tiger gives birth only to cubs, not the kids. Reproduction, producing the same ones. Here the cell division is mere like this. Let us observe the binary fission in amoeba. Here you can see the cell division as well as the reproduction in the binary fission of amoeba. Observe this video carefully, then you will find the answer how cell division takes place and also how new organisms arise by cell division. This is amoeba. You are observing, this is the nucleus. See what is happening in nucleus. These are the chromosomes. Nucleus is divided slightly. And it is moving forwards the poles of the amoeba. Nucleus is completely divided now. Okay, two equal amounts of cytoplasm and two equal amounts of chromatid is shared between these two nuclei. We call it as offspring nuclei. And later what happens? See, the division takes place in the cytoplasm. Because of the division in the cytoplasm, two amoeba produced here. Two daughter amoeba produced here. Single amoeba cell. Amoeba is a unicellular organism. Unicellular means it has only single cell. Single celled amoeba divided into two cells here. That means cell division occur. And at the same time, reproduction occurred here. Reproduction means same cell is produced. Amoeba, initially the parent amoeba looks like this. And the amoeba produced from this also looking like the parent amoeba. In this division, what happened? Amoeba produced the daughter amoeba that looks as the parent amoeba. Okay. And you can observe this under microscope also. Here is the division taking place in amoeba. It is divided into two equal halves. Fission means breakdown here. Binary fission. Binary means two. It is dividing or breakdown into two equal parts in the binary fission. Because of this binary fission, two daughter cells or two daughter amoeba are produced. Later in this field, Walter Fleming worked. The period of Walter Fleming is 1843 to 1905. In 1879, Walter Fleming examined many kinds of animal and plant cells and selected those that showed a division. He reported from his observations of such cells that there was a string-like structures. I think you observed in amoeba there are string-like structures in nucleus. He found this. Which one? There were string-like structures in the nucleus which split longitudinally during cell division. What he observed, there is a split in the thread-like structures or string-like structures. There is a division occurred in that string-like structure longitudinally. He named a process of division as mitosis. Mitos means fine threads. Here, the division took place in the fine threads. So that is why he named it as mitosis. As the dividing structures resembled threads, he made a meticulous observation and made sketches and observed that there were a sequence of events in the process of division. You have seen there are first the chromosomes become shorter and later the metaphase occurs, the fibers, spindle fiber formed, and the chromosomes moved towards the poles, and finally division occurred in the nucleus, and later cytoplasmic division, the division cytokinesis, we called it as the division takes place in the cytoplasm, later two daughter cells are formed. The sequence of events occurs in the process of division. A decade later, these fine thread-like structures were named as chromosomes. So first chromosomes are identified by Walter Fleming in cell division in nucleus, especially, but he did not name it as chromosomes. Okay. See, these are the fine threads observed by Walter Fleming. This is DNA present in chromosomes. This is chromatid present in the nucleus. This is the cell and this is the nucleus. These are the chromatids. And later another one scientist worked in this area. His name is Wilhelm Rox. The period of him is 1852-1924. Rox proposed that chromosomes carried a different set of heritable elements in longitudinal splitting observed by Fleming. Fleming told there is a splitting observed in the fine threads during cell division. It is also observed by Wilhelm Rox, and Rox especially find one interesting character, that is, heritable elements was carried by these chromosomes. That means the parental characteristics, the characteristics of the parents are transmitted to the offsprings or the younger ones through the chromosomes. The chromosomes, while cell division, chromosomes are transmitted through from parent to the progeny or the younger one. While chromosomes are transferring from parent to progeny, this characteristics also transmitting at that time. That means chromosomes are carriers of the characters. Okay. This was already mentioned by Gregor Mendel in 1866 on paper on heritable elements in peas. He worked in the plants peas convey his results about the genetical characters, heritable characters. Okay, this is also observed by Wilhelm Rox. In cell division, the cell divides into two halves with equal number of chromosomes, which are similar to parent cell and are diploid in nature. I want to tell you one thing, children. Cells of our body and all flowering plant cells are in diploid state. Diploid state means each cell has two sets of chromosomes, that is diploid. That means here, if one cell is divided, the cell which contains diploid sets of chromosomes, if the cell division occurs in that cell, two daughter cells are formed. Two daughter cells also contains diploid state. That means chromosomes are equally transferred to the daughter cells. That means what is happening here, the chromosome number will be doubled before the cell division. At the time of starting of cell division, chromosome number is become doubled. The doubled chromosomes are equally shared into two daughter cells. Then only this diploid state continue to the future cells. See, this is the cell. You are observing, this is the nucleus. In nucleus, you are observing the genetic material. This genetic material has the double helical structures, DNA. These are the chromosomes, it contains DNA. Why chromosomes number is constant over generations? This is the question which scientists struggled a lot. Why the chromosome number is constant? If the cells has diploid state, if the sperm and egg cells fuses together, sperm cell has 46 chromosomes and egg cell has 46 chromosomes. Those two cells fuse together means 46 plus 46, the chromosome number in the zygote should be 92. Then it is not happening like that. 92 chromosomes are not coming. Only 46 chromosomes are present in the zygote. That zygote again converted to embryo. Embryo to seed, seed to plant, or that zygote converted to embryo. Embryo to animal. younger animal, baby. So why this is not happening? Why chromosome number is not increasing in the generations? What is happening? This is the question in the minds of the scientists. See, if you read here, when cells divide, the daughter always have the same number of chromosomes as the parent cell. Number of chromosomes present in the parent cell is equal to the daughter. Let us assume that cell division is always preceded by mitosis. In mitosis division, equally chromosomes are shared, equally cytoplasm and other parts are shared into the daughter cells. If this mitosis division occurs continuously in every area of the life of the living organisms, what should happen? That should be happened like this. In case of man, egg cells and sperm cells, like other cells, must contain 46 chromosomes in human. Okay, but if this were so, then the union of egg nucleus and sperm nucleus, which takes place during fertilization, would produce a total of 92 chromosomes in zygote. If 46 chromosomes egg cell, 46 chromosome nucleus is united or fused in fertilization, the zygote should form it with the 92 chromosomes. If it continues, this would be in next generation, in next generation cells, the chromosome number will be 184, and next generation 386, and so on. The chromosome number will be increases generation after generation. But the situation is not like that. Chromosome number is not increasing per generation by generations. What is happening? Chromosome number is static. It is not changing. The number of chromosomes 46 in this parents and next generation, and the next generation also containing the same chromosome. So what is happening? There is another one division that occurs in cells, that is found by interesting man. He is August Weismann. The period of him is 1834 to 1914. August Weismann, biologist, hypothesized that in successive generations, individuals of the same species have the same number of chromosomes. In successive cell division, the number of chromosomes always remain constant. So the chromosome number is not increasing. In all generations, all individuals has the same number of chromosomes. This is the generalization by August Weismann. He is a great scientist. Why I am saying as great means, just listen or look at him, look about these words. August Weismann was a scientist with poor eyesight. He can't able to see properly. It was difficult for him to use a microscope to study the cell. You all know cell is a microscopic one. If you want to see the division in the cells, we should use the electronic or compound microscope. So he can't able to see under microscope because of poor eyesight. But there were other things that he could do. Even though he can't able to see, but he can do some other things. What is that? What he did? Advancement of science is not only possible by mere collection of data. Someone must think, analyze and interpret the data. What he did? The collection of data which were the scientist who worked previously, he collected all those data and he studied it and he think over it and he analyzes the data and tried to interpret that data. August Weismann's poor eyesight forced him to spend time thinking. See, think how great he was. Even though he has poor eyesight, he did not give up. He think, analyze and interpret data. Finally, he said some generalization. These are the generalizations made by August Weismann. Okay. Finally, it was proved. What is that? There is some other division takes place for the number of chromosomes always constant. The chromosome number is not increasing. So what is happening here? Sperm cell and egg cell is not diploid in state. See, one set of chromosomes present. It is in haploid state. The fusion of sperm and egg cell form zygote, fertilized egg cell. This single cell undergoes many mitotic divisions. First mitotic division, two cells form. These two cells contain same number of chromosomes. So the chromosome number is same. There is no reduction here. And these two cells undergo again division. And this new four cells are formed. The chromosome number C. The chromosome number is C to the parent cells. And these four cells undergo again mitotic division. Here eight cells are formed. These cells also contain the same number of chromosomes. Like this way, mass of cells, a group of abundance of cells produced by this mitosis division in the egg cell or embryo in the zygote. From those mass of cells, different organs are produced, like bone, muscles, skin, eye, glands, blood, other organs are developed in the embryo. Each and every organ has the cell that is in diploid state. Their chromosome number is same as the zygote. All the cells has the same. What happened? This is mitosis. Mitosis means here the cells, the daughter cells, chromosomes are similar to the parent cells. Chromosomes and the matter, the cytoplasm, equally divided into cells. That is mitosis. Here another one division taking place, that is meiosis. What is happening in meiosis? See, this is the reproductive cell. Reproductive cell present in the female reproductive system or male reproductive system. This may be the female reproductive, think this is the male reproductive system and also female. What is happening in this female reproductive cell? Meiosis division occurs. Because of the meiosis division, cells formed, but this cells has the chromosome number. See, this is in 2N state, but the sperm cell and egg cell is in N state. N means here single set of chromosomes. This is in, these are in haploid state. What happened here? Chromosome number will be, chromosome number is reduced here. Chromosome number is reduced to half N. 2N chromosomes are reduced to N. That means chromosome number is reduced to half here. This is also a same. Sperm and egg cells are produced. If this meiosis occur in female reproductive cell, egg is formed. This meiosis occurred in male reproductive cell, sperms are produced. Sperm and egg is in haploid state. These two are in haploid state. If these two fuse together and participate in fertilization, what happens? Sperm and egg cell, these two are in haploid state. If these two combine together and forms the zygote. That zygote, N plus N, 2N state zygote is formed. That means here not only meiosis, mitosis, meiosis, meiotic division also occurs in cells. Where meiosis division occurs in our body, especially in the reproductive cells, not in all cells. In all somatic cells, that may be the skin, muscle, a gland, blood, there only mitotic division occurs. Especially in the reproductive cells, meiotic division occurs. Because of the meiotic division, chromosome number will be reduced to half. That is very, very most important here. So that is why here chromosome number is reduced to half. After that, the reproductive male and female gametes fusion, two sets of chromosomes of zygote is formed. So again, these zygote has the two sets of chromosomes as to the parent. Okay, so the chromosome number is constant like this. So chromosome number is not increased. If meiosis is not occur, what happens? 2N state reproductive cell is divided, two cells are formed, that two cells contains 2N, 2N. This 2N means, these two fusion means 2N plus 2N, here 4N state zygote may be formed. if meiosis is not occur, that may happens. So because of meiosis only, here chromosome number reduces. Okay, that is happening in our body. The scheme of mitotic division was confirmed, and meiotic division also confirmed in 1904 by Theodore Baveri. The chemical nature of the genetic material was determined after a series of experiments over the next 50 years. The later on study the structure of deoxyribonucleic acid, that is DNA, double helical structure, is discovered in 1953 by James Watson and Francis Crick. These two scientists discovered the structure of DNA, and they studied well about this the structure of DNA. In the final saying by scientists about cell division, scientists proved that mitosis takes place in all body cells which retain same number of chromosomes. Meiotic division takes place in sex cells where the chromosome number is halved. Halved means half here. Okay. You understood, I think, now. In body cells means if red blood cells should produce, if our body needs red blood cells, the division takes place in the red blood cells which are already present in our body, that is mitosis. If in human body sperm cells should produce, there what happens, meiotic division occurs in the male reproductive system. Because of that male meiotic division, sperm cells produce, that sperm cells chromosomes are reduced to half. Okay, this is how cell division occurs in the body of living beings. Summary: Robert Remark first published an article about cell division. Walter Fleming find division of fine threads in nucleus during cell division. Later, these fine threads named as chromosomes. Wilhelm Raux proposed chromosomes carried a different set of heritable characters. Chromosome number is constant in successive generations of same species. August Weismann hypothesized that there might be another type of division occurs in cells to maintain the chromosome number same for generations. Theodore Baveri explained the mitosis, and in 1953 Watson and Crick discovered DNA. Scientists finally proved that mitosis takes place in body cells which retains the same number of chromosomes. Meiotic division takes place in sex cells where the chromosome number is halved. Evaluation: how do you appreciate the work of August Weismann? Explain about his contribution in cell division. What is the final discovery of scientists about cell division? Why chromosome number is constant in successive generations? What is the use of genetic material in living organisms? Thank you, and I will meet you again with another topic. Until then, bye.